Hey, what's up? It's Jim, and I just got back from the new film, The Comedy. Swanson, played by Tim Heidecker, who is indifferent to the prospects of inheriting his father's fortune and spends most of his time with his older hipster friends, played by Eric Weierman, James Murphy of LCD Sound System, and Greg Turkington, who is also known as Neil Hamburger. And they make up his older hipster friends who hang out around Williamsburg and just kind of create mischief, fuck with people, get drunk, and don't take anything particularly seriously, and have a lot of irony and sarcasm to their general demeanor. They have conversations just to push the limits. They don't really have real conversations. They're just always fucking around. They're always joking around. And Tim Heidecker's character, Swanson, is always kind of refusing almost to acknowledge what's going on with his father and that his father's dying. Instead, he's just fucking around with his friends, like they're messing around in the church. He pays a guy $400 to drive his cab and then tries to pick up a girl like she's a prostitute, despite the fact that she's not a prostitute. He just likes to create trouble. Tim Heidecker plays like a trust fund baby. We're all used to him in Tim and Eric, and this is very different from that, although he does interject the same kind of Tim and Eric humor within his performance, especially when he's with his older hipster gang. And Eric Weierman is in it, but it's not a Tim and Eric movie at all. Kind of change of pace for him as a performer, as kind of an older trust fund baby Brooklynite, really doesn't have any responsibilities. He's just, you know, fucking around, and just because his father is sick, that this is the only time that he has done this. I pretty much think that this is his life. He's looking for a cheap thrill, he's looking for something to do, and that's like his entire life. If you live in Brooklyn, you have landlords like this, you have neighbors like this, and we all know this character. Tim Heidecker does it incredibly well. He is that character. New York and any urban city is known for is these people who have money, who just use the city as kind of their personal playground. And how clueless he is. He really thinks he can just fuck with people, and this is an amusing thing to do. Although I like all the performances, and I think what they're saying with it comes across very well, how sarcasm is really hollow. I feel like they are all like kind of too old because they're particularly kind of commenting on kind of hipsterdom, and that's something that when you think of a hipster, you think of someone who's young. I kind of feel like maybe this statement would have meant more if it had picked a younger cast. However, I like everyone in the cast. Maybe I'm wrong about the hipster part. It's more talking about kind of trust fund Brooklynites rather than hipsters. And in that case, I guess it is rather effective at what it's doing. It is a little too slow for its own good. It has all these parts that some of them connect very well. And I think when he's hanging out with his gang, it works really well. But when he gets the job as a dishwasher, I kind of don't understand how that connects, because it's almost like, why would he get a job if he has all this money? It's another thrill for him, maybe, I guess, when he meets this waitress and they go back on his boat. That part, I don't understand, like, exactly what they're trying to say with some of those parts. It, like, just kind of fell flat for me, and sometimes I think this film is often a little too slow for its own good. It felt like the film didn't really know where it was going. I mean, I understand it was shot quickly. I know it was improv'd, quite a bit of it, but that often showed in the film, not in a cool Cassavetes way, more in a like, well, this is what we have, so we put it in. I think a lot of it is really smart at how it's trying to show kind of the emptiness and the shallowness of this kind of a lifestyle, and particularly saying something about wealth. A lot of trust fund babies like this start meaningless charities and try to pretend like they are really going to do something, but he's not looking for a way to legitimize himself, but I think he's ultimately lonely. Like, he won't admit to himself that the irony and the sarcasm and all these things he's doing to people, he's like an overgrown child because he's not given the true fact of responsibility. A lot of these Brooklynites and a lot of people around the country and wherever, if you're given an endless bank account, you don't have to show up for work every day, you're just kind of meaningless. In certain parts, I think this film's a lot like its character, because as much meaning as it has throughout showing him, oftentimes it does feel a little meaningless. It's 90 minutes, which isn't a long film or anything, but it could have been a little shorter. It just kind of ran on and lost its meaning in certain parts, whereas other parts I think it expanded upon it very well. It kept losing its point, and maybe like that's the point of his lifestyle. I don't know. I ultimately, though, while I was watching it, I liked it more in theory than the actual film itself, but then when I thought about it and thought about the theories and kind of read more about it and thought about that, I like what it was doing and I like what it was saying, but I don't think I really enjoyed it as a piece of art. But I do respect it and what it was trying to do, and I do think it's interesting. So if you have seen the comedy and you would like to talk about it, then comment below in the comments, and subscribe if you would like to. And you know, for a film that's called The Comedy, it's not funny. It's not that funny. I guess that's the joke. Get it?